Hey, it's me again. In this video, we're going to talk about the amazing gallbladder part 4. Okay, so this is the last video in the series. And there's a couple more things I want to share with you. Number one, the gallbladder releases bile that helps break down fat. But it doesn't break down fat all the way to the smallest particle. It needs help by this thing called the pancreas. The pancreas and the gallbladder work together to break down these fats. So if you are substituting bile into the diet or a purified bile salt and it doesn't fully solve the problem, it could mean that the pancreas is not releasing enzymes because the symptoms of pancreatic enzyme deficiencies are very similar to a gallbladder deficiency or a bile deficiency. Okay, so you have to kind of understand that there could be that too because they both work together. So this pancreas makes a fat enzyme called lipase, and that really works to help take that breakdown of fat all the way down to the smallest particle so you can start absorbing it and start using it. So that's very important. Now, also there's some studies that show that having enough bile will prevent fibrosis. Now, what is fibrosis? That's the scar tissue that builds up in the liver. Fibrosis of the soft tissues, that's like scar tissue. It's like connective tissue that just kind of plugs everything up. So I just want to point that out because if you have fibrosis, one of the things that I found when I'm doing research, if you take purified bile salts, that can improve that condition. So you might want to do research in that area. Next thing I want to talk about is cholesterol. People are freaked out because of cholesterol, but they don't really understand what cholesterol is. They think cholesterol is a fat. Cholesterol is not a fat. You've heard of HDL and LDL. Do you know what it stands for? High density lipoproteins, low density lipoproteins. They're proteins that carry fat through the body, and the purpose of that cholesterol is to actually help heal parts of the body. So if there's some type of inflammation in your arteries, it's called a lesion, that cholesterol will come in there and start healing it up like a Band-Aid. And if you don't understand that, you're going to think that, oh my gosh, my cholesterol's too high, I'm going to get clogged arteries, when really it's just trying to heal your arteries because you've eaten too much sugar or junk food. So cholesterol is not a bad thing. It's like it just tells you that the body's trying to heal itself in some way. And to have someone tell you you need extreme low cholesterol, like down to the hundreds, like way down low, like 100 or below 100, I totally disagree with that, because there's just as many problems health-wise from low cholesterol as there is high cholesterol for your immune system, cancer. Why? Because cholesterol is needed to help heal the body and protect the immune system. Cholesterol actually is needed to make bile. It's needed to make stress hormones. I mean, think about it. Your liver makes 2,000 milligrams of cholesterol every single day. Why does your body make that much if it's bad? It's not bad. It's good. And because it actually is, it's good in the right ratio. So you shouldn't be afraid of cholesterol. You just need to realize that we want the right amount of it. We want the exchange, the good and bad. We want that at the certain amounts. And if the cholesterol does go high, it either is because you're eating too much sugar or alcohol, or you might not have enough bile to help break down that cholesterol. So a very important point. Okay, another point. In your thyroid, thyroid produces a hormone called T4, and a lot of times women take, and men take, synthroid. That's T4. That's the inactive form of thyroid hormone. Well, did you know that that gets converted through the liver to T3? But if you don't have enough bile, you can't convert it. So a lot of times your thyroid problem is really not a thyroid problem. It's a gallbladder liver problem because the conversion isn't there. So here you are taking all this synthroid for years and years and not seeing any results because this is the culprit. In fact, the original cause of your slow thyroid could be this area right here. Important thing to know if your metabolism is slow. So this, I'm telling you, the importance of the gallbladder is it's huge. Okay, there's a couple things that can cause this gallbladder and the duct to be smaller or pinched off. And that could be stress, because high level of cortisol going in the system, or estrogen. too much estrogen can also mess up the gallbladder, and that's why females that take hormone replacement therapy or even birth control pills or even go through a pregnancy when they have this huge spike of estrogen and they end up with a gallbladder problem. Well, guess where it came from? Excessive estrogen. And then people have questions about the gallbladder formula I have. I'm just going to tell you what's in it. This is an extra strength version. I just added a new ingredient because I wanted to add all the pancreatic enzymes. So it has pancreas enzymes. It has purified bile salts. It has betaine hydrochloride. So that actually helps your stomach. It has slippery elm bark to help lubricate this area right here. It has stone root to help break down any stones. So it's a really great combination to help support a healthy gallbladder. So I hope you enjoyed this series. And if you have any questions, please post them below. And I'll see you in the next video.